Good evening.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Welcome to our wonderful tradition here at Temple Emmanuel to do a concert right after Thanksgiving. And today we are going to celebrate the life of the maestro, Leonard Bernstein, and Bernstein. What is the right word? Bernstein. There you go. Yeah, wonderful. All right, so for many, Leonard Bernstein is known, you know, like this famous conductor of the New York Philharmonic who played all over the world. In this part of the country, he's known like the Jewish boy from Lawrence, Massachusetts. And so Leonard Bernstein was born, as I said, in Lawrence, Massachusetts, 100 years ago. And when he was a child, he moved from one apartment to the other with his parents, different towns in Massachusetts. And then, interesting enough, he attended a synagogue, Mishkan Tefillah. He and his family were members of Mishkan Tefillah, at the time was in Roxbury. And what is fascinating about this is that Leonard Bernstein always credits the musical director of the synagogue as his highest influence in music. His name was Solomon Braslavsky, and basically I'm going to quote Leonard Bernstein, or Bernstein, whatever. He says that, "I used to weep just listening to the choir, cantor, and organ thundering out," but Bernstein recalled in 1990. He actually dedicated parts of his symphonies, Jeremiah and the Kaddish, not Jeremiah Berman, but Jeremiah the symphony, to Braslavsky, and actually help him publish his music, Braslavsky music. So another fascinating part of the story is that Leonard Bernstein attended Boston Latin School as a high school, and then he went to Harvard and graduated from Harvard. While he was at Boston Latin all the years of high school, he lived just a few streets from here on Park Avenue, and actually in the same exact house of one of our beloved members, Gary Oren. He and his wife and children grew up in that house, the same house where Lenny lived all the years when he went to high school. Fascinating. And then obviously he went to Harvard, graduated from Harvard. At the time that was very hard to get as a student, being Jewish because of the quota. And then eventually became the greatest composer and fascinating conductor. Bernstein has written symphonies, concert works, theater works, film scores, and ballet scores. Fascinating. So we are here to celebrate his music, and we hope you enjoy this event tonight. I'd like to introduce Loy David. He's somewhere here. He's going to say a few words. He and his family are sponsoring this concert in memory of Lucia David. Loy, please come.
Hello, welcome to this. This is our seventh concert that we've sponsored in honor of Lucia. Lucia Myerson David was born in Bolivia and then moved to Chile until she met me and we got married and I kidnapped her to the United States. She was a great fan of music, especially Latin music. And her favorite music of all time would have been West Side Story. So now we will have the honor tonight of listening to Elias and the others sing songs from West Side Story. So I thank you very much for coming and enjoy the show.
So we are going to begin the concert with first song, you can see it in the screen, there we go, Mass, simple song. So this show was written in 1971. It was commissioned by Jacqueline Kennedy in order to do the inauguration of the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C., 1971. And she wanted a Mass, and for a Mass, she contacted two Jewish people, Leonard Bernstein and Stephen Schwartz, who helped writing lyrics for and beautiful music for these magnificent piece. So, simple song. You are going to hear that the text is based on Psalm 121.
And one of the things I love about this song is you can hear in the funky chromaticism, in the melody, that angst you get in the middle of winter when it's cold and freezing and dreary and gray, and you're trying to convince yourself it's going to be warm again sometime soon.
Oh!
So several months ago, I thought it could be a good idea to do a concert honoring John Bernstein in the 100th anniversary. And so I thought about doing this music, which is, as you can see, not so easy to do. And I thought about who can be the musicians playing at this concert. So I contacted Jeremiah. Actually, Jeremiah contacted me and said, you know, Elias, do you know if you need me for the concert of Bernstein? And I thought, need you? And then Jeremiah, on his own, said, can I do the arrangements of all the single instruments that are playing tonight? Jeremiah, it's an honor and a pleasure to work with you, and we feel privileged here at Temple Emmanuel to have you with us. So as you can see over there, there are three sailors, actually, coming to New York. That's the story of this show, On the Town. And interesting enough that you may know that pretty much in those days, I don't know if it's still the case these days, but many shows that wanted to go on Broadway, they would premiere in Boston first, they would preview them here first, and then they would take them to Broadway. So this was the case on the Town, that the premiere was in December of 1944, and it was exactly 2 weeks before its debut in New York. An American Navy ship docks in New York during World War II. So Gaby is the character of the song that I'm going to sing. He's one of these three guys. And the only thing that he wants in New York City is to fall in love and to meet girls. And it's not my case, obviously. And basically, he sees the poster of a famous artist and he wants to track her down and to be able to meet her and probably to date her. But he's not very successful. So he feels very lonely. And this song is called Lonely Town.
Gabe is coming to town. So what? Who cares? Back on the ship, it seems such a snap. You tap a girl on the shoulder. She turned around and she said, I love you. But once on shore, it's not such a snap. You get the cold shoulder, the old run around. You are left with no one but you.
here tonight, Rosie, for the next one.
Great to be here. This is another song from On the Town, where the sailors and the various interesting women of New York are starting to fall in love with each other. Except that they realize that soon the sailors will need to return to the ship and it's possible they may never meet again.
Away.
Away, away, away.
You get carried away.
When I go to
show, and I'm watching at the CSA. I start to think what's happening is really so. The girl who must protect her, the alien don't respect her. I need to learn the fence of much of what we're to the sea. To keep in touch, but I get carried away. Try to act, less will be heard, but I get carried away. When shopping, I'm a sucker for a bargain sale. If something is marked down upon a shelf, my sense of what's practical begins to fail. I buy one and another, another than another. I buy the whole store and a Christmas for myself.
When I go to see my friends up on the train, golly, how I hate to see them go. But then my love of traveling I can't restrain. The time to run is parking, the train's already starting. I have the freight and in a flutter.
We get carried, just get carried.
always a challenge, but I'll give it a try. It's sort of like an extended dream or nightmare sequence where these characters gradually lose their innocence and positive view of the world by various horrible things that happen to them. Various characters die and come back to life with no explanation, and they travel all over the world. So at one point, they run into this person who's known as the old lady, who serves as sort of a mentor to the young, beautiful, and not particularly innocent Cunegonda, and explains that the way she has survived is because she is so easily assimilated.
So in this very complex plot, actually, this song has nothing to do with what she sang. Actually, Candide has taken many different versions and many different plots from the original version of it. So it's fascinating. The music is gorgeous, but it's very hard to understand. So this song is called It Must Be So. It's a very somber song. It's because Candide, the main character, is in love with somebody who happens to be the daughter of the Baron of somewhere, and the Baron doesn't consider that Candide is a good candidate for his daughter, so he's sent into exile. So Candide lost everything, and he's singing this song that is called "It Must Be So." Oh, we could have done this song before. We should have done this song before. But you never told me.
Are torn apart by circumstance, and Kunigunda finds herself working as a courtesan, something she never imagined. And though she acquires the wealth she dreamed of, she doesn't have the life she wants.
Give me
So I hope that you understand that we are singing songs and we are not those characters. I want to clarify, you know, you just saw a rabbi doing a prostitute and pulling jewelry from somewhere that won't go on our website. I was singing a love duet about having a dream home in Germany and feeding the pigs. Kosher. Anyways. So now we are in West Side Story, this fabulous show that Leonard Bernstein wrote. I don't know if many people know this, but originally the show was meant to be called East Side Story. And he started writing this show in the 1930s, and the whole idea was to do a mixed marriage between a Jewish boy who falls in love with a Latin girl. But he abandoned that project. He started working on the project again in the 50s. That was when the whole migration of Puerto Ricans were coming to New York City. So he decided to do something more current in a way. So he named it West Side Story. If you pay attention to the beginning, the very beginning of the show, you can hear the sound of the shofar. And Leonard Bernstein has done many of the compositions taken from Jewish parts of music, Jewish parts of the liturgy, incorporating that into the show. So this is Maria.
The most beautiful sound I've ever heard. Maria, 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 Maria. All the beautiful sounds of the world in a single word. Maria, 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 Maria. I've just met again a Maria, and suddenly that name will never be the same to me. Maria, I've just kissed again a Maria, and suddenly I found a wonderful sound. Can it be Maria? Say it loud and there's music playing. Say it soft and it's almost like bragging. Maria, I'll never stop saying Maria. Maria, I'll never stop saying Maria.
In this moment, they're singing about America.
Mm-hmm. okay by me in America. Everything be in America. For us all be in America.
I like the island of San Juan.
I know a boat you can get on.
Hundreds of flowers in full bloom.
Hundreds of people in each room.
You have to think positive.
I feel pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty, witty, and bright. And I pity any girl who isn't me tonight. I feel charming, oh so charming. It's alarming how charming I feel. It's so pretty that I hardly can believe I'm real. See the pretty girl in that mirror there. Who could that attractive girl be? Such a pretty face, such a pretty dress, such a pretty smile, such a pretty face. I feel stunning and entrancing. Feel like running. Such a pretty face, such a pretty dress, such a pretty smile, such a pretty face.
sing some different characters tonight. I was singing Anita before, and this is a song of Maria's. So in this scene, Tony and Bernardo have been as part of a fight between the two gangs, and Tony has killed Bernardo, and he's actually the brother of Maria and also Anita's boyfriend. So Anita's trying to argue to Maria that their relationship should end because of that. But Maria explains that she's in love with him, and that's not going to change based on their now very difficult circumstances.
Against the odds for love to work.
Together with
So we'd like to thank all the band members for playing tonight. I'd like to introduce them.
Elaine Baker, Chancellor of Luke, and Jeremiah Kramer.
Thank you. In the back, David Beckham. Beckham. David is really an angel. He actually helps all the time, and he's done three things tonight: sound, lights, and the projection. So thank you so much, David. We want to thank Kenny Sharpman for all these beautiful slideshows with the stories. I want to thank my wonderful colleagues, Rosie and Aliza. Fabulous job. Thank you. To many people who made this concert possible, Sandy Thau, Penny Sharpman, Mary Miller, all everybody in the music committee, and Aaron Mosley for publicity, all of you for coming, and especially to Lloyd David for the support in memory of Lucia. So please stay for the reception. We have wine and cheese in the back, and actually now that's on community hall. And let me explain you how it's going to work. So, normally, we sing the last song, then we go out, everybody starts clapping, and we come back for the encore, all right? Now, we have the encore written in the program, so you better clap, all right? Because we have to do this song. Okay, so you understood. Rosie?
Tonight, it will be.
You may be seated.
So, this is the finale for Candide, and it's a place that all of the characters, after trauma and loss and discovering that the things they thought they wanted weren't actually what they wanted, have come together and decide to live a life based on good, pure values and hard work.
Oh!
Thank you.